If you don't have a Webfile account, view our How to Create a Webfile Account video to learn how to sign up. If you already have an account, let's continue.
This video explains how to Webfile pay taxes and fees. The Webfile online filing system is available 24/7 through the Comptroller's website. Let's get started. Enter your user ID and password and select Login. The eSystems menu page allows you to access electronic filing, sales tax applications, franchise accountability questionnaire, CMBL, Hub, as well as others. The Webfile Access page provides you with the ability to view accounts that have already been added to your profile, and you can also add new accounts. To file, return, or pay for an account you have already added to your profile, click on the taxpayer number next to the account. To add a new account, enter your 11-digit Texas taxpayer number and click Continue. There are two columns on this page, Assigned Taxes Fees and Available Taxes Fees. Under Available Taxes Fees, you will see a list of taxes that can be assigned to your profile. Click on the tax that you would like to file for. Enter your Webfile number. This appears on correspondence sent to you from the Comptroller. Your Webfile number begins with the letters RT or XT and is followed by 6 numbers. If you don't know your Webfile number, check out our How to Find Your Webfile Number video in this channel. Read the access disclaimer, check I agree, and click on Continue. Your access rights will be confirmed. Click Continue again. Once you have successfully assigned a tax, you will see the name of the tax in the Assigned Taxes Fees column. Taxes listed under the Assigned Taxes Fees have been added to your profile. If you do not have any taxes listed, you have not assigned any to your profile. Click on the tax that you assigned. We will now look at the reporting and paying menu for your Webfile account. The functions available on this page vary based on the type of tax you selected. This example shows our sales tax menu. You can only pick one at a time. We will go over what each section does. At the top of the list, you have the option to file a return. You can pick File Original Return or the File Amended Return functions. You will have the choice at the end of the return to make a payment. Or you can also choose to make a payment only. If that's what you're looking for, select that function and click Continue. Another option on the list is the View Return Summary function. This is available for most tax types. After you file the return, you will be able to see the return data we have on file for the taxpayer you selected. Select View Return Summary and click Continue. This is similar to what you will see in the View Return Summary page. This page provides a list of returns for your taxpayer account organized by period. The period 1407 in this example represents the July 2014 period. If you do not see any history, then no returns have been filed for the taxpayer you selected. Otherwise, click on the period for the return you have filed and click Continue. Then you'll see this. This is the Return Summary page. It provides a summary of the specific report you selected. The total amount due and payable may not reflect all discounts. You can go back by selecting Return to Menu. Finally, the last function on the list allows you to view the history for your electronic submissions. Select View Transaction History. The View Transaction History page lists all of the returns and payments you submitted on your Webfile account. Remember, you can go back to the tax menu by clicking Return. Now that you have assigned your taxpayer number to your account and are familiar with navigating Webfile, you can file a return, make a payment, or add additional payer accounts. If you experience any issues or need assistance, call 1-800-442-3453.